of brick. I heard the birds chirping and apple choir warming up in the distance. I was reminded of a line from the great poet Walt Whitman, who wrote, "I hear America singing," and I thought, aren't we the song that we sing? Don't we lift our voices to show the world who we are, what we believe in? So I ask you this morning, what song are you singing?
People leaping into the air already. She comes, seems a million miles away. But we're barely hanging on, especially with my foreign eyes. There's not too many places we can stay. Beneath mom can find a job that's steady. Maybe I can stand it for a year. And maybe things won't be so bad. And maybe I will miss my dad and need to even start a new life.
Easy sexuality, relaxed morals. I hear rock and roll and the endless chant of pornography. I ask myself, why does our Lord allow this? We all know He has the power to turn all those books and records and videos into one big fiery cinder like that. And why? Because the Lord is testing us. He's testing to see whether we will choose His path, which is why every day we must ask ourselves, have I done the right thing?
And when will Mr. McCormick McCormack be joining us?
Mr. McCormack won't be joining us.
My husband and I are separated.
He ran off to find himself.
Then, please. Won't you join us, Mrs. McCormack? Lulu has made some of her famous cookies, and she wants to show us what heaven tastes like.
Only if you call me Ethel.
Only if you call me Vi.
Save me a cookie, Ethel.
So, Ren, you all set for school tomorrow?
Oh, you don't have to worry about that. Coach set us up in school last week.
Reverend, have you heard that our new English teacher wants to introduce some vulgar modern novel into our American Lit course?
Yes, Slaughterhouse 5. I've received several calls.
Wait, Slaughterhouse 5? Cool book, right? Cover to cover. That's one bitchin' story.
Do you read much?
Well, Coach, maybe in another town.
In any town, Uncle Wes.
Tom Sawyer is a classic.
Excuse me, Daddy. Rusty and the girls are going for burgers tonight. Can I go?
Tomorrow's a school day.
Oh, Daddy.
Ask him.
We already did. And she said it was her and that you said. Is that okay with you?
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock. Great sermon today, Reverend.
Thank you, Rusty.
I especially like the part about Walt Whitman, rock and roll, music being in your soul. I was like, hoo-hoo!
High praise indeed, gentlemen.
I, on the other hand, thought my daddy was never going to shut up.
Oh, Adam, you just talked to him.
What good would that do? He doesn't listen to me anyway. And besides, welcome to Beaumont.
Howdy.
Ooh, you are cute! Wendy Jo, isn't he cute?
Aww.
I bet he knows he's cute, don't you think, Wendy Jo?
Aww.
Hey!
Ooh, baby! You got that sweet stuff!
Girl, put your tongue back in your mouth and let's get going!
See ya! And where do you think you're going? Where do you think?
Ooh!
And if anybody asks, I was with you guys all night, right?
Are you asking us to laugh for you?
Yeah. Okay!
So who's that new guy at church?
Who? Oh, him! He's our new classmate. A Chicago transplant with all of the charm and sophistication that comes from living in a bustling metropolis.
Should I be jealous?
I'm counting on it.
Hey, Cranston. So what are you doing with a preacher's daughter? Anything that I want?
Oh, yeah? What's she get out of it?
Anything that she needs.
Like you know.
Girl gets around. She calls me.
I went to the bird blast. Your friend suggested I may find you here.
Oh, we were just on our way.
Your mother thought you might get caught.
Evening, Reverend!
Serious?
And I will see both of you in my office after school. Okay? I'm both sure what places will be.
Oh, it's against the law. You're not allowed to dance in this town.
Get out. Is he serious?
Oh my gosh, Will! The way you just bumped your friends from Clark, that was like the most words you ever put in a sentence ever!
Chin up, Mr. McCormick. It is such a turn on watching a guy fly in the principal authorities.
So, was he serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing's against the law.
Has been for the last 5 years ever since an accident.
Wait, what accident?
The Potomac Bridge accident!
You've never heard of the Potomac Bridge accident?
If I had, I'd be doing this.
Ladies, do you mind if I take this one?
Please.
There were these four guys we all grew up with. They was traveling back from a dance on Barbados Kevin. Now, maybe it was just the rain that night, and maybe they was driving a little bit wild, but they lost control of their car, skidded across the bridge, through the rails, and got 35 feet to the Potomac River!
God, did anyone survive? God.
Yep. And when the sheriff's office published the autopsy report, it said there was alcohol and marijuana in their blood. Well, the whole town went nuts.
And that's when Reverend Moore got so righteous, he started blaming anything and everything. Drugs, liquor, rock and roll, you name it.
And dancing.
And just like that, a law was passed.
Wait, Reverend Moore has that kind of power?
Reverend Moore, he is the power. He is the law.
Man, how can you all stand to live like this?
Practice. Years of practice.
Oh, it's not like Chicago. Oh, it must be so nice to live in a place where you could just walk down the street and get mugged by somebody you don't even know.
Yeah, I miss that. You know, I thought living in a small town was going to be perfect, like one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. There's tons wagging every time you make a
room. There's fingers pointing every time you turn around.
There's dance shaking every time you cross the line. And there's eyes.
Somebody, 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 somebody.
you get fired.
Every day it's more bad news than you, every day. Zachary.
Oh, Ethel, now hush, you ain't helping things.
Ran, what did happen?
I think I should be fired for. Willard came by the store and he wanted to change the dollar, so I popped up the register and made the government pay. This on my head, and he went crazy. He accused me of stealing.
That's because everything you do makes people suspicious.
Are you on drugs?
No! Why don't you frisk me? I'm sure you've already been through my room.
Poor man, just apologize to your uncle.
Look, young man, I know I'm not your father, and you can say that again.
Wes!
Ethel, don't say anything.
I can't do that, Wes. I don't know how to do that.
Hush, Pumpkin, please.
Oh, look, I realize that we have guests in your—
Ethel, house. Now hush! Right now, just don't say anything!
Never mind.
Choking, learning to be silent. what my favorite part is?
I like the part where King Arthur and Camelot fight over Guinevere. It's right after Mordred comes in and he's like, I'm the king, I'm the king, I'm the king.
What? You read a book.
Cliff note. Took me forever.
It's even better in the book. There's all these knights on horseback jousting and storming the castle.
All we did is guys in overalls with pickup trucks.
Hey, Willard.
Ha. How y'all doing?
I'm doing all right.
Hey, Russ.
Hi, Willard.
We'll see ya.
Hey, Willard. That's it.
You two are pathetic.
What are you two gonna have a real conversation?
Oh, Willard's not capable of a real conversation.
I kind of like that, guys.
Well, it's my second day and I haven't been fired yet.
You may have found your future.
I may have. What can I get you?
Diet Coke. Diet Coke?
I will have a double patty cheese melt burger with extra mayo and an order of fries and a diet Coke.
And Ariel, what's your pleasure?
Oh, it's not on the menu.
Chuck sees you flirting with Ariel, you're dead, man.
She usually doesn't even remember me.
Well, that uniform makes you look like such an asshole. It's easier to pick you out.
Why do you need to fight, aren't you, brother?
My mom says in my nature.
Shut up. Tell me what you know about Ariel.
I know she's been kissed. A lot.
Uh-huh.
And she's into you like a hard-on slut.
Get out of here.
Ariel likes trouble. And you have proved to everybody in this town that you are T-R-U-B-L.
Come on, I was only teasing him.
Oh, that was more than teasing. Red from out of town, and don't tell us that don't make your toes curl.
You wanted a Beaumont so bad, I bet you memorized bus schedules.
You told us you read books just to escape to other worlds.
Exactly, and books I get to meet guys who amaze me. And what about Red?
What about him?
Well, he's so smart, kind of tall.
And I think he's handsome.
Cute, maybe.
But can he compare to Chuck Cranston, the rugged but dangerous high school dropout slash drug dealer who was recently evicted from a trailer park? I don't think so.
Hey, what's the deal with you and Rusty?
Bates me. I think she's good looking and all, but she talks faster than any girl I've ever met. I never know what the hell she's talking about.
Because she's ain't horny.
You think?
If only I could find a guy who made his first move.
If only I could find a guy who, when he went to kiss me goodnight, he'd take the toothpick out of his mouth.
If only I could find a guy. Where have all the good men gone? And where are all the gods?
Yeah!
Where's the streetwise Hercules to find a rising knot? Upon the fiery street.
going on?
Chuck,
we had a date half an hour ago.
I'm sorry.
I don't like you making a fool out of me.
Yeah, well, why would you? You make such a good job for yourself.
Shut up, Rusty.
Will you be joining these ladies for dinner?
When I say meet me at 8, what am I talking to myself?
No, Chuck, you're right, I'm sorry, calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down! Don't ever tell me what to do! I know what your friends think of me, and it's bullshit. I'm the best party there is in this town, and those three dogs are tied up and thrown under the porch. Let's go.
No.
Get in the truck.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no, what part of that don't you understand?
Oh, when the preacher's daughter says no, it just makes me hot.
Get off, Chuck.
I believe the lady said no.
And I believe this is none of your business.
Then don't.
Errol, who invited this clown?
Oh, we haven't been introduced. I'm Ren. Ren McCormack.
Get your hand out of my face. And your face out of my sight.
Hey, Chuck, you're looking for a father.
Well, that's safety and comfort of one of your most valued husbands.
You think this is funny?
Crafton! Your pickup truck is parked in a handicapped space, which is a space reserved for people with physical, not emotional, disabilities.
You ever seen the last of me, McCormick?
Somebody please let me kick this ass!
What is it your mama always says? Before you make a fist, make sure it's your fact.
Yes, ma'am.
Willard, this is not your fact. Now, don't the rest of you have a curfew? And McCormick.
Yes, ma'am. I'll turn my skateboard.
Listen, I'll see you back here after school tomorrow.
Really? So I'm not fired.
Not yet. Now get back to work, you.
Yes, ma'am.
You are either very brave or very stupid.
What do you think?
I haven't made up my mind yet. Want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
Oh, yeah. Please, my daddy invented it. But don't you think rules are made to be broken? Come on!
You love that, don't you?
That way, he'll notice when I'm gone.
Where are you going to go?
College, for starters. I want to speak 5 languages and see the world. My daddy wants me to teach English Lit at Baylor County. They don't even speak English at Baylor County.
I can't picture you as a teacher.
Thank you. Me neither. I think I'll leave that one to my daddy.
He's a preacher, not a teacher.
Yeah, when you're good at it, it's basically the same thing. And he used to be real good.
What changed?
His mind. He closed it.
I noticed.
He used to be so open, so inspiring. I've seen him give hope when hope was gone. I've watched him change lives.
If you love him so much, why have you always got to take him off?
I didn't say I love him.
Boy, do I know what you mean. My dad.
Yeah, what happened there?
He left. One day, he just packed his things and walked straight out the door. No goodbye. Nothing.
Whew. Bet you got a lot to say to him.
Lots.
Like what?
I couldn't.
Safe to the train. I do.
God! How can you be so stupid to leave Bob and me? I hate you!
Yeah.
might as well dance parties in the whole Tri-County area. Good research.
One cigarette, about to have both. Now I should come home again.
Well, come on. rusty.
Hold on! Hold on! This is a date? You said to go for a drive. You asked Aaron if not rusty. Well, like I'm on a date with you!
You look so handsome tonight.
Well, thank you. The thing is, you put me in the back of the crazy lady. Don't stop moving and don't stop talking!
She's excited to be with you.
Well, sure that. But the thing is...
Yeah?
Between you and me.
Uh-huh.
On the first date. Really?
Yeah.
Okay, that makes me feel a whole lot better.
Right then, let's dance.
What? Dance? Dance? What the hell did you think I was talking about?
When you said you couldn't do it, I thought you meant a...
Oh, hell, any idiot can do that. I can't do this. I can't dance.
You hear that, Don? Your boyfriend says he can't dance.
Come on, give the guy a break.
But that ain't natural.
Yeah, it's like falling off a log or riding a bike.
It's like learning to swim.
I can't swim.
Oh, fellas, why'd you save me from in the deep end?
Ariel! Ariel!
She's not here,
no.
Chuck. Did I scare you?
No, not at all. Did you tell Ariel that...
Yes, Chuck. I told her every time you called.
Thanks. I guess she's busy at all.
She and the girls went over to Wendy Jones to study.
Really? I was just there. Wendy Jones said she left hours ago with Rusty.
Oh.
Who is it, guy?
Mr. Cranston.
Evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel.
Isn't it a little late?
Yes, sir. That's why I'm surprised she's not home.
So am I. Good night, Mr. Cranston. And please remember, next time we have the front door for guests.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she went to Wendy Jones to study. Don't bother calling. She's not there.
So how does it feel, Vi, now that she's lying to you?
I'm not saying anything until I've heard an explanation from her.
It was bad enough when she was running around with that Chuck Cranston. But now she's out there with that punk who's challenging me and the entire town council. How long can you keep defending her, Vi?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where have you been?
Me and Rusty and Wendy Jones.
Don't even bother.
You know you weren't Wendy Jones.
I can't believe you're checking up on me.
Honey, how do we know that you're not sick or hurt?
I'm concerned for your well-being.
Well, then how come when I'm here, at home, no one cares what I'm thinking or how I'm feeling, but the second I walk out that door, wham! Suddenly you're concerned.
Sure, she doesn't mean that.
Stop taking her side. It's time she answered for herself.
I don't know what good that would do. You don't listen to her any more than you listen to me.
Sure.
I'm gonna hit anyone.
No.
We're losing her, Vi. She's becoming willful and obstinate.
Like her father.
I'm a spiritual guardian.
You used to be her friend.
I don't know what to do anymore.
Yes, you do. Can you find it in your heart to forgive her? Can you stop and see there's part of her that's trying to obey, while part of her is dying to run away?
Fell apart.
at my mama's knee. Now anytime I'm turned around, I turn to mama first. And you'd be wise to memorize what mama says to me. Now, mama ain't been wrong yet, not the hidden truth. It's time to fry your thought away there. Mama says don't use a toaster while standing in the shower. Now who can argue with that? Mama says don't hold your breath for so longer than an hour. The woman knows where it's at.
Good ideas.
Hear me now.
Mama said,
what you believe is
all
that goes. Ooh, do not believe that. She's right.
Mama said,
if you've got doubts, boy, you're not alone. Just means you're ready.
All those dreams we saved for.
A licensed pet is a happy pet that takes care of old business.
Thank you, Voodoo. Now let's consider a new business. Before we begin, I want to remind all our young people who have joined us this evening that this meeting is convened to consider official town business. Disturbances will not be tolerated. The floor is now open. Yes.
My name is Rennell Cormack, and on behalf of most of the senior class of Beaumont High, I move that Local Ordinance 416, the law against public dancing within the town limits of Beaumont, be abolished.
And now will our hero of 385 Cloverdale Road would like to second that motion.
Eleanor, may I have the floor, please?
Certainly, Reverend.
Wren, you would like to change our law so that you may throw a dance. That is your right. But it is my duty to oppose any enterprise which, in my opinion, harbors the use of drugs, liquor, but most importantly, celebrates spiritual corruption. And I think you're going to find that most folk in this community agree with me.
Yeah, you got that right.
Now, if anyone here can convince me that your raucous plans are safe, then I may reconsider. But until then, I'm afraid, no, I cannot condone it.
I believe a vote is in order. Will all those in favor?
Excuse me, isn't there some sort of discussion first?
Yeah. This is outrageous.
Roger! Roger, sit down. I believe Mr. McCormack has a right to be heard.
Thank you. Well, I just wanted to say a few words because I think this idea scares a lot of people, and it shouldn't. From the oldest of times, people dance for many reasons. They dance so that their crops would be plentiful, or that their hunt would be good. They dance to show community spirit, and to celebrate, and that's the dancing we're talking about now.
Mr. McCormack, we do not need a history lesson.
Excuse me, Griffin. I'll be told in Psalm 149, to praise ye the Lord, sing unto the Lord a new song, let them praise his name in the dance. And it was King David, who we read about in Samuel, King David, and what did David do? David danced before the Lord, leaping and dancing with all of his might. Leaping and dancing. And Ecclesiastes assures us that there is a time to every purpose under heaven, a time to laugh, a time to weep, a time to mourn, and a time to dance. There was a time, it is law, but not anymore. Dancing's been around since the beginning of time to celebrate life. This is our time. Thank you.
Order, order. There is a motion on the floor to repeal Local Ordinance 416. How does the council vote?
No.
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 The motion is defeated, and I believe this meeting is adjourned.
Ren, up till now I've been pretty proud of keeping my thoughts to myself, but honey, if I don't say something, I'm gonna bust.
What's there to say? I lost.
Sweetie, you never had a prayer.
It's not funny, Mom.
Ren, when you got to the pen about leaping and dancing and laughing, which I love, don't get me wrong, but faces of the town council, and Reverend Moore had those votes wrapped up before he even walked in here tonight.
Wait, you think he told them how to vote?
You can still sound surprised. I love that about you.
He's a man of God.
He's a man. And you a railroader.
Damn, that pisses me off.
Good. Now listen. Reverend Moore said he would only reconsider if someone could convince him that there was no danger in your raucous party plans.
Raucous party plans? Do you believe these people? What?
Make him reconsider.
Me?
You.
And him?
Yep.
When?
Now?
But
Ren!
Mom!
Stop! Until you do, you're never gonna make peace with that man. Or in this town.
Didn't convince him in here.
He wasn't listening in here. Make him listen.
Reverend Moore, sure is a smart man.
So are you.
He's stubborn.
And you're not. Listen, Brad, just speak from the heart. I mean, I'd love to stay and watch, but I've got to go and hose down your aunt and uncle.
I love you, Mom.
You have no choice.
Hey, Rusty.
throw a clean sheet over the front seats of my pickup so we don't end up smelling like the dogs.
Uh-huh.
My daddy's still kind of fits and I can roll up the pants legs with duct tape.
I like where this is going.
Mama can whip us up one of those croissants.
Corsage.
One of them.
Well, you're painting a real picture for me, aren't you? I see a rusty pickup that smells bad, a suit made up with brown tape, and a corsage made up with God knows what.
So what do you think?
Is there a dance in there somewhere?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm weird! I'm a lantern!
Don't even think about it.
It was a good thing you did this morning, George.
Still not sure if it was the right thing.
I think it comes close. I've missed you. I've missed us.
Hard to figure out sometimes, well then I apologize, but you are dearer to my life than you could ever realize. If I try to make amends, can you teach me how to start? Can you find it in your heart?
I'm Thank you.